Well, calm is being restored in central London after a day of violent protests. Thousands of students took to the streets to demonstrate against government plans to increase university tuition fees and slash teaching budgets. The widespread unrest saw missiles being hurled at police, windows smashed at Whitehall, and several people injured. Authorities say over 30 arrests were made for criminal damage and public disorder. School and university students engaged in local rallies all across the UK. Oliver Adam from the EU referendum campaign says ordinary people are being made to pay for Downing Street's bad decision making.
People are angry enough that they're actually doing something about it. They're doing something about their anger. And they're fed up with a government that is basically saying, you know, we've got no choice but to do this, no choice but to do that. And really what the government is saying actually is, we know better than you, and your opinions don't matter a jot. And these students have seen through that finally. And so hopefully, you know, this will snowball, and other people that at the moment, for example, are unhappy that we're prepared to give billions away to other countries just to kind of try and shore up their credit rating rather than invest it in education and transport and jobs back here. Perhaps they will start to take to the streets, and, you know, hopefully something more will develop from it. What would help the austerity measures, of course, some people would say, would be, for example, leaving the EU. We're spending £48 million every day in staying in the EU. Portugal is almost certainly going to need bailing out. And the big problem, of course, is Spain, because it's a huge country. So we could seriously be seeing a collapse of the euro. And a lot of people would say that not before time. And why should Britain be bailing out countries that were foolish enough to join the euro in the first place?
And elsewhere in Europe, public discontent is mounting as the single currency plunges into deeper crisis. It's feared Portugal could be next in the line for EU aid. The country was paralysed by a 24-hour general strike on Wednesday ahead of a parliamentary vote on a tough new budget due later this week. Meanwhile, the Irish government has unveiled a four-year plan to save 15 billion euros and stabilise the debt-ridden economy. The country will adopt the harshest austerity measures it's ever faced, including massive job cuts and tax rises. It comes as Dublin negotiates a bailout package from the EU and IMF. But some experts say a new approach to the single currency is necessary for a total recovery. The IMF
are going to give us a bailout. People forget that before these budget cuts, we had other budget cuts. In Portugal, we are going to the third round of budget cuts. And Ireland, a while ago, people were telling us that they had already done the most that they would or could or should in budget cuts. And still, markets do not leave them in peace. So what happens is that the euro has institutional weaknesses that are weaknesses not only of the peripheral economies, each other very different from the other, but difficulties, weaknesses of the whole common currency. So they should be addressed as a whole and not by pinpointing to budget cuts in one or the other economy. If the interests keep raising, well, what happens is that budget cuts that we are doing today will be ineffective tomorrow, and we've seen this movie already. So I think that a whole new approach is needed.